simple machines, understanding levers. You must have tried to open a tin can like this sometime. Congratulations! You used a lever. A lever is a simple machine. What is a lever? It's a rigid rod with a fixed support. A lever is a rigid rod with a fixed support. Rigid means something that does not bend out of shape. It is stiff. This rod is rigid. This rod is flexible. So, the back end of the spoon acts as a lever and it helps us open the lid. Let's see how and why it is a lever. A lever is defined as a rigid rod with a fixed support. The spoon is a rigid rod. Where is the fixed support? The outer edge of the can where we rest the spoon to push it under the lid is the fixed support. The fixed support of a lever is called the fulcrum. Can you spot the fulcrum now? The place where we apply force on the lever is called effort. Where is the effort in this lever? The force by our hand is the effort. The thing that we actually want to move is called load. Where is the load in this case? The lifting lid is the load. Look at this farmer using a strong crowbar to remove the big stone bogged in the farm. Such a machine is called a lever. A lever is a simple machine. Man has probably been using levers since prehistoric times. Why is this a lever? It is a rigid rod around a fixed support. It is being used as a simple machine to lift the rock. In this lever, can you spot the fulcrum, load, and effort? The fulcrum is the support. The effort is the man's force. The load is the rock to be moved. A lever is a very simple machine that makes it easier to do work. A lever has three parts: fulcrum, effort, load. Fulcrum is the support. Effort is where the force is applied. Load is the object to be moved. Place a pencil on a table, a ruler at a right angle to it, and a weight on one end of the ruler. Press the other end with your finger to lift the weight. Can you identify the load, effort, and fulcrum on this lever? Depending on the position of the fulcrum and the load, we have three kinds or classes of levers. Fulcrum in the middle, load in the middle, effort in the middle. There is an easy way to remember this. Just remember the word FLE, flea. It tells you what's in the middle. Fulcrum, that is F in the middle, load, that is L in the middle, and effort, that is E in the middle. What kind of lever is this? The fulcrum is in the middle. Remember flea. F in the middle is a class 1 lever. This is a class 1 lever. What kind of lever is this? The load is in the middle. Remember flea. L is in the middle is a class 2 lever. This is a class 2 lever. What kind of lever is this? The effort is in the middle. Remember flea? E in the middle is a class 3 lever. This is a class 3 lever. What did we just learn? A lever is a simple machine. A rigid rod that turns around a fixed support to do work is known as a lever. A lever has three parts. Fulcrum, that is fixed support, load, that is object to be moved, effort, where you apply force. There are three types of levers. Class 1, that is fulcrum in the middle, class 2, that is load in the middle, and class 3, that is effort in the middle. Hint, you can remember what's in the middle and the class of the lever with the word flea. So you know the three kinds of levers. You know the main parts of a lever. Fulcrum, load and effort. Now let's see how we use these simple machines in real life. A seesaw is an example of a lever. You can see the fulcrum. The elephant sitting on it is the load. The mouse trying to lift it up is the effort. What kind of lever is this? The fulcrum is in the middle. Remember flea. F in the middle is a class 1 lever. A crowbar is an example of a lever. You can see the fulcrum. The man's hand pushing the stick down is where the effort is. The stone he is trying to move is the load. The fulcrum is in the middle. F in the middle is a class 1 lever. Scissors are an example of a lever. You can see the fulcrum. The man's hand pushing the blades together is where the effort is. The cherry he is trying to crush is the load. The fulcrum is in the middle. F in the middle is a class 1 lever. How does a bottle opener work? The opener is rested on the cap and we apply a force on the opposite end of the opener to pull it upwards. A bottle opener is used as a lever. The fulcrum is where the bottle opener rests on the bottle cap. The man's hand pulling the bottle opener up is where the effort is. The actual bottle cap that is being lifted up is where the load is. What kind of lever is this? The load is in the middle. Remember flea. L in the middle is a class 2 lever. A wheelbarrow is a lever too. How does it work as a lever? Think about where the fulcrum, load and effort are at. Look at how a wheelbarrow is used. The lever is supported at the wheel, so that is where the fulcrum is. The boy's hand lifting the wheelbarrow is where the effort is. The stuff in the wheelbarrow is the load that is being lifted. What kind of lever is this? The load is in the middle. Remember flea. L in the middle is a class 2 lever. When we carry out a push-up, our body acts as a lever. The body is supported at the toes. So that is where the fulcrum is. The man's arms are lifting up the body. That is where the effort is. The body weight that is being lifted is the load. What kind of lever is this? The load is in the middle. Remember flea. L in the middle is a class 2 lever. Look at how a nutcracker works. The handles are supported at the end, so that is where the fulcrum is. The man's fingers are pressing the nut. That is where the effort is. The nut that is being cracked is the load. What kind of lever is this? The load is in the middle. Remember flea. L in the middle is a class 2 lever. Look at how a stapler works. The handles are supported at the end. So that is where the fulcrum is. We press it somewhere in the middle. That is where the effort is. The pin comes out at the other end. That is where the load is. What kind of lever is this? The effort is in the middle. Remember flea. E in the middle is a class 3 lever. How does our arm behave when we do a bicep curl? The arm is supported at the elbow. So that is where the fulcrum is. We lift it with the power of the forearms. That is where the effort is. The load is the weight that is being lifted. What kind of lever is this? The effort is in the middle. Remember flea. E in the middle is a class 3 lever. How does a tweezer work? The two arms are joined at the end, so that is where the fulcrum is. We use it by holding it somewhere in the middle. That is where the effort is. The load is the thing that is picked at the end of the tweezers. The effort is in the middle. Remember flea. E in the middle is a class 3 lever. How do we use a cricket bat? The bat can be moved around the end. So that is where the fulcrum is. The place where we hold the bat is where the effort is. The load is where the bat lifts the ball and hits it away. What kind of lever is this? The effort is in the middle. Remember, flea. E in the middle is a class 3 lever. How do we use a broom? The broom can be moved around the end. So, that is where the fulcrum is. The place where we hold the broom is where the effort is. The load is where the broom moves away the dust. What kind of lever is this? The effort is in the middle. Remember flea. E in the middle is a class 3 lever. How do we use tongs? The place where the two arms are connected is where the fulcrum is. The place where we hold the tongs is where the effort is. The load is where we pick things up with the tongs. The effort is in the middle. Remember flea. E in the middle is a class 3 lever. Did you know Archimedes was the first scientist to understand and explain how a lever works? He understood the mathematics to calculate how much effort is needed to lift a certain load and where to place the fulcrum. If you calculate properly, you can really lift an elephant using a mouse. So, Archimedes said that if he had a support and a very long rod, he could even lift the earth.